Hey guys, I am going to be repotting my Kimberly Queen today. I just got her yesterday. And of course she's in a little nursery pot. I'm going to be putting her into this size pot. See some roots, but not a whole lot. I'm just going to clean some of this old dirt up. Give her some air. And I like to clean up any dead looking leaves or branches that might need to be cut off. Just kind of pull them off if I can. Otherwise, I just use my little scissors. I really like these. I have planters out front in my garage, which she won't be going out there now because I will get another one of these, and I like to put them out in those planters because they grow really nice right there to the north. And they get a lot of water. I do have some new growths popping up. That's one great thing about fern. They are not hard to take care of. Okay, now I got her cleaned up, and this is the pot I want to put her in. What I'm gonna do is, this does have a little tray at the bottom of the pot, but I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna put some styrofoam balls in it anyhow, because I like to water and I have to be a little careful. If you are not a heavy-handed waterer, you may not have to do this stuff. And then I've already got my dirt all mixed up. For my ferns, I like to use a, let's see if I can move this, just kind of fogging light, there we go. For my ferns, I just like to use, I use a 4-to-1 ratio of dirt and a little bit of peat. So that's how I do it. I'm just going to put some dirt down here to the bottom. And I want to see how she looks. Well, that looks pretty good. I like to leave my plants just a little shallow at the top. That way I can water them in really well. So then I'm just going to take her fill her sides and top them. I also mixed a little bit of, I tore apart some of the foam packing peanuts. I just save them from when I order plants and what have you, mail, stuff like that. Mostly when my orchids come. So then I'm just gonna top her off. She's in there pretty good. And she looks like she is pretty much straight. Now, if this would have been an older fern, you know, and it had a massive root ball, I would have probably cut the bottom of that dirt and root ball I would have just cut about anywhere from an inch to 2 inches. I've had a lot of big Boston ferns, and man, they get huge, and the root balls are just absolutely crazy. And you just, it's just easier to cut them and get that bottom mass off there, because they will grow more roots. Ferns are great about roots. So, all right, there you go. There's my Kimberly Queen. And I will just water her down. I'm going to put a little more soil in here because I mushed her down a little bit. And there we go. She's got about, oh, I'd say about a half an inch of dirt from to the top of the pot. Like to leave it a little shallow. That way when you water, your dirt don't splash out. And make a mess all over wherever you're watering, in your house or on your front porch or wherever. So, all right, now I will just, I'll go water her in and feed her. And I just feed my ferns and all of my house plants the same way I feed my orchids, weekly. I use quarter strength fertilizer every time, and on all my house plants, all of my orchids. I have Peters and I have Miracle-Gro is what I use. Actually, I think, well, right here. Better Grow Orchids Plus 2014-30, and then I also have a 2020-20, and I have a lower Peters. I also put, I have bone meal, and I will do that right before, with this watering, I will put my organic bone meal, and, I put this on all my plants too, just like, I don't really measure it, I just take a few pinches and sprinkle it around, and then I water everything in, so. Yeah, that is what I use, and you guys have a great day. Bye-bye.